On the shtick, we're here today at the Jewish Museum of Australia. There's been a beautiful event to celebrate the birthday, 92nd birthday, of Sir Zelman Cowan, who's been very involved in the Jewish Museum. And we are now with his son, his oldest son, Rabbi Dr. Shimon Cowan.
Pleased to meet you.
We've known each other a long time. But I just wanted to ask you, what is the secret of Jewish genius and success?
Well, it's a very interesting question. It could be answered on a practical level, and it can also be answered on a more mystical level. Practically speaking, I think we can say that the Judaism as a tradition. Now, Judaism, of course, for the most part, has been religious tradition. If it's not religious, it fades out pretty fast after a generation. The religious tradition is one which has always placed a premium on learning. The Jewish people, the people of the book, are people of learn, not just people of the book, but are people who learn the book, learn the books. And there is, and I don't know if there is any other culture which is as much absorbed and as much instructed in the actual on daily process of learning, effort to understand, to question, and grasp the tradition which they've received. So, you could say simply that there is a long history of intellectual exertion in Jewish culture. I think we could also give actually a more spiritual and mystical explanation of as follows. We believe that the Torah, which was given by God, is in fact not only ultimately the source of ethical wisdom and goodness, it is also a source ultimately of all of the arts and sciences. Now that may make you, that statement like that may make you fall over initially. And it's a difficult concept, it's an abstract concept.
It is.
But from this divine wisdom actually do descend the secular wisdoms. Not in a way in which I can actually even elaborate in such a short time that we're together now. However, it is not surprising to my mind that a people whose spiritual makeup is attuned to the Torah should not also therefore be also receptive. Their spiritual intellect, so to speak, should also be a receptor in some sense for the arts and sciences which come out ultimately from the Torah. Now these arts and sciences as they come out, the fact that they descend from the Torah doesn't mean that they're always true in the sense that they always conform with Torah. Because in the process of emergence, there can be all sorts of twists and turns. There can be corruptions. Nevertheless, whatever is true in art and science is in Torah. So whatever becomes of art and science, in other words, even though it goes off in all different patterns, there is a core, there's a spark in it, a spark of truth, and that descends from Torah. So in a sense, it's not surprising that the people of the Torah should be those who are, many of those who are receptacles of those sparks, which then grow into various kinds of arts and sciences, some of which are harmonious with Torah, some of which are not. So that's, if you like, a little bit of a mystical take on the subject.
So Simchat Torah is happening this week. It's an annual event where we celebrate the receiving of the Torah.
That's right.
What does Simchat Torah mean to you?
Simchat Torah is many think of it as just a day of of sort of rowdy festivity, but in fact it's quite a sublime day. It's as great as Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. The notion of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur is that, as we know, we stand there in shul, ascending to connect with God. And these are days of awe, when we sense the remoteness of God and we want to reattach to God. Simchas Torah is a time of the unpacking and the revelation of godliness down below. As one person,
holding it,
and
run around the bima.
As one rabbi, Rabbi Mattis Ganser,
passing the Torah to each other.
It's called bringing Torah down to the bootstraps.
Oh.
And whereas we thump on the floor with dance in a circle, but this circle, in fact, just like a circle has got no beginning and no end, it's a symbol of infinity and of transcendence. That's what's happening. We're bringing the divine transcendence down to ground level. So it's a wonderful time. It's a time of great revelation, of great holiness, great godliness, and therefore it's Simchas Torah. It's the Simcha with the Torah. The Torah is the manifestation of godliness in the world.
And just for our viewers, in case they don't know what the Torah is, it's the five books of Moses.
Five books of Moses, but not only that, it's also all of the totality of commentary.
Mm.
Thousands and thousands of works of commentary which elucidated both the legal commentary, the mystical commentary, the Kabbalistic commentary, the whole works.
And you are into the Noahide laws.
Well, the Noahide laws is a very strong interest of me, of mine.
Yes.
The Noahide laws, briefly, are the laws which constitute the universal message of Judaism.
And there are seven laws?
There are seven of those.
Yes.
And so the seven fundamental laws, they relate, they are prohibitions on killing, prohibitions on theft, prohibitions on various forms of cruelty to animals and destructive relationships with the environment, injunction to set up processes of justice, strictures relating to personal sexual morality, and also laws relating to blasphemy and idolatry. Prohibition of both, needless to say.
And you are a doctor in laws.
I'm a PhD. I'm a doctor of philosophy.
In philosophy.
But I have a very... I actually did it in social philosophy long ago. But I suppose you could say that Jewish philosophy, in many ways, is my primary interest.
Right.
Well, and Jewish law.
Shimon, it's always been great to have you on the show. We have had you on the shtick before, and I can assure you we will have you back again.
I'm looking forward to it.
It's great to celebrate your father's birthday today. He is really one of the men who I think belongs in the pantheon, as in Sir John Monash and Sir Isaac Isaacs. We have had a few of those who have really made a big impact on the society they live in and within their Jewish folk as well, because I think that we all have a foot in both fields, because our Jewishness is central to our life, but we also have to live with the rest of our world.
There's no doubt about it, and I can say that my father is actually the patron of one of my own organizations, and he supports Torah activity as well as the full gamut of socially useful and beneficial activities, and I'm as greater, or if not probably a greater recipient than any other.
Well, you're a lucky man. Thank you, Shimon.
All the best, and be well, and have a good Yom Tov.
Thank you. And what do you say on Simchat Torah?
You can say in Hebrew, Chag Sameach.
Chag Sameach.
You can say in Yiddish, a good Yom Tov.
A good Yom Tov. Thank you. Chag Sameach.
Chag Sameach.
To all our viewers. I love the shtick.